What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. And today we're here at Otter Creek and we're going to be taking on Birdie Alley.
I'm going to get to use my whole bag, which is primarily Underworlds.
And I'm going to be throwing mainly putters. So it's going to be like a Chief and a Houdini and probably my throwing wizard. So should be a great video, guys. We're going to be playing Birdie Alley, trying to shoot really low on this final nine. I'm looking for 9 under would be great, but there's a couple tough holes. So I'm looking at maybe at least 5. So it's a his and hers face off. Hopefully I'm married by the end of this video. Let's get into it. It's already starting off bad.
Look at my little squatchy. He's sad. You gotta stop looking so sad, little buddy.
Well, we'll get 2 because this is hole 1. And ace.
Oh.
Come on.
Oh. I'll take that for a first.
Ooh. I'll start out with a wizard, I guess. I mean, I don't know if I need one or not. Come on. Like slid up to the basket too. That's too straight. Wow, that's bombed.
It's fine.
It's all right. It just went way too straight. I don't know. They're both about the same.
I don't know if that's a person.
Or an owl. Ah. Otter Creek, you gotta be like really careful because the baskets aren't gonna catch as easy as you think.
Sounded like a person going ca-ca.
They're trying to catch that crow that's out there. Taking some notes from Dutch.
Yeah, coming for
making
you.
A bag putt. All right. Give us a hole breakdown.
Hole 2 of Birdie Alley. Let's see if we can get it.
What do you gotta do to get it?
I'm just looking at the stuff. See where I need to point. I see YouTuber in the wild.
So we're on hole 2 of Birdie Alley, which is hole 11 on the original Otter Creek course. You're just really wanting to go down this little tunnel shot, and then it's a little sweep and hyzer. So it's... You can't see the basket. It's pretty much dead straight through all of this junk. All of this tall stuff is thorns. You don't want to be in there.
It's no fun. You don't want to be in there.
Oh, that's clean. Jess is throwing an Underworld there. This is pretty good uphill as well.
Oh, don't roll that down the
hill. That was a Houdini. It hit the tree in front of the basket. That's crazy.
Forward march. I got kind of scared of it, like hitting the cage and rolling down. It's a nice little ramp for it now.
Oh, they put in some new things here.
Yeah.
These new logs keep it from washing out. And here, even that is a scary putt because that's like 15 footer, maybe. Probably not, maybe 10. And if you don't just like lay it in the basket, it's not staying.
Putt with paradox.
It's a little tap in 3 action. I'm 2 for 2 in Birdie Alley so far.
Aboo.
I don't know what to do here. Part of me wants to throw the wizard just dead straight. It's kind of a shorter shot. But I've been throwing a little flex with his Houdini. Now in the 70s, they didn't have a Houdini type disc. They would have had to thrown a wizard here, or a midnight flyer is what they would have called it. I think I'm gonna throw a wizard straight at it. Oh, should have used the Houdini.
You in the thorns, sir.
I'm on the edge.
Do not. Oh. Are we kidding me? That's like the best
line. One of the best rips you've had.
I've had. We both messed up this hole. But it's almost winter time, and this course gets a whole lot easier.
All right. That may be a putt. I'm going to flip this. It's probably, what, 45, 50, 50 footer? Oh. Oh, man. Player B just doesn't miss. That had to be a 50 footer.
Probably do need to get that out of the basket, though.
Yeah, let me do that. Woo! Banged it. Nice putt, babe.
Thank you.
There you go. Uh-oh. Come on now. Oh, dang.
I just forget how well I did.
Hey!
You got a birdie on camera.
That is the first time I've ever been filmed disc golfing.
Uh-oh.
And me and my buddy David Ackerman, and this was back in 86, we were in a horror film, and we were playing disc golf at Silmar Park, and they were filming a horror film there, and
you were in the horror film?
Yeah. Huh? You couldn't tell who it was, but we knew because we were there.
There you go. Well, it may make it on YouTube now.
That?
Yep.
Well, you don't need no patents right from me. You can use it all you want. I'm brag. I got a birdie on 12 and called it.
His almost, it was the ace run.
Oh, God, was that pretty.
It was nice.
And that little limb said,
smack. Chief time. So this hole is, I don't know, it's just very weird. There's a mando on this tree because a lot of people, I guess in the wintertime, they go this route over here. It's pretty much almost a horseshoe of a shot to get to the basket. It's tucked way to the right. So I normally just throw a chief up through here and just try to get it to stay on Annie. That's going to be all right. I think it's going to be a little straight, and I'll just have a little pitch up to the basket for a three.
That's crazy.
Just throwing a paradox into the abyss. Kick out.
Thank you.
It did. A little rough.
I hate this hole.
It's pretty rough.
I think I'm going to smack this thorn right here. I just struggle so much.
Now we're looking at maybe 100 foot, like a little wizard shot. A little short, but my camera's over there. Oh, Otter Creek, you scare me. That was a good putt, and it was the one that almost went out. The bad putt stayed in.
No chains.
So that was an adventure on hole 13. I got a par. Jess got a four with a big putt. I'm shooting two under. I didn't get all the birdie alley, almost. Now we're into like professional birdie alley. Your advanced players are going to want to birdie all these. This is kind of an S shot. You want to actually just go dead straight. The basket's just behind this tree in the middle. I throw an S shot with a Houdini and just try to get it to flex back at the basket. It's a pretty good pump. It's like 301. It's almost what I want out of that Houdini. I actually flexed it a little too soon. I wanted to throw it more flat.
Thank you. That would have been
so close. That was still good, but that would have been parked.
That would have been into the thick of it.
I don't know. It looked like it was going to be Park City, Utah.
Nope. Ooh. Two left.
That's all right, though. There's more of a putt there than it looks. Another 80-footer. Almost got it. In it. That's a long putt. Oh.
Ding.
Diggle, diggle. Well, here's my throw in that didn't throw in. My Houdini that didn't Houdini. This is why we don't throw this shot, kids. Because now you would have like that kind of putt to try to make. That's a whole lot more tough than this little putt right here. It's probably going to bounce out now that I said that.
Peek-boo. A-boo!
Still two under. I've got how many holes left?
Four.
There's nothing on this. I was looking to see what the number was. It's gone.
Coming for you, Dutch.
Pretty wide gap off the tee, but throwing a putter on a hyzer and trying to get it to stay on hyzer. So I'm throwing a chief. It's 315 feet. The basket is all the way to that wall of trees in the back and then dead left. I'm going to be putting a chief on quite a bit of hyzer and trying to push that back wall and throw in kind of max distance.
You did it.
That's pretty good for a chief. That's probably maybe 250, somewhere around there. And I'm hitting this gap off the tee. That's the main goal, is to not hit those trees. Yeah, I'll step. Come on, smash.
Woo! Maybe one of my best drives on this hole.
Yeah, like super rip. Oh, chill.
Whoa.
All right, little S shot, putt, hyzer putt, upside down skip shot. Pick. We're all three, technically.
I would do a hyzer putt, but.
Hyzer putt?
Yeah.
Putt. That's a little too inside for my comfort. Now, let's see. More risky, but the more makeable putt is this. So let's just see. Same spot. Bonus shot. Not wide enough. A little straddly. Oh, you may have a little
thorny.
Oh. Oh. This is the tougher of the nine. Whoa. I wound up with a three different ways. This is probably the last easy birdie. Oh. I got scared. I mean, it's a chief. I got scared of hitting this tree, so I didn't give it enough for it to turn up. Oh, baby. That is
my best drive.
Super nice.
Here. Ever.
10 out of 10.
Still won't make that putt.
Oh, you'll make that.
It's the haunted hole.
This is the haunted hole. I don't know if that used to be a foundation or what's up. That's like a 15 footer. 9 times out of 10, I missed that putt.
Oh, curse is broken.
Now, twice or it's luck on the curse, not the putt. I've got a wide open putt here.
Yeah, that's honestly the best side to land.
Well, missed that putt.
Fumble.
Oh, that's sketchy. There's more of a putt. The first one like hit here and then fell in. That's three under. I got two holes left. I have to birdie both holes with a putter to get five under on the back nine. This is, it's like the disc golf dance. This hole's about 290 feet. It's just kind of straight and then hooks to the left. The problem is it's kind of all uphill. So throwing a chief and getting a chief all the way there is pretty tough for my noodle arm. We're gonna rip it.
Ah.
I just can't get the height. Like, chiefs go really far to be a putter. I just don't have the arm speed to push it. And I don't know, like, my ankle's been hurting quite a bit. So I think subconsciously, a lot of times that'll keep me from planting as hard as I can because it winds up kind of hurting this part of my ankle. Excuses, you know. Ooh. Nice rip, babe.
Just like, apparently I warmed up on the last holes.
That could be a real thing because most of the time you hit birdie alley by the time you're warmed up. So like, you've already played 9 holes, hopefully getting some birdies on those, and then you hit birdie alley and you've already got a little bit of steam rolling, you know. You matched my chief. Starting to catch up to me distance wise.
Well, and you're like, that's a fairway versus a putter, but it's like, the distance is the distance.
Yeah. Well, and I mean, the thing is, like, if I threw a driver, all it would do is help me shape the shot better.
Yeah.
But yours is, like, literally right it's behind, like, mine.
Yeah. Flipped up to...
We have the same putt.
Like, highs are flipped.
Nice shot.
Not in it, but right at it.
Gotta make this putt. This is a 50 straight uphill. I just took a chief, birdied it with the same disc, and like, you know, a couple tries.
So now all you have to do is ace 18 and you'll be good.
Maybe if I had a forehand, I could ace 18.
Uphill.
Can I just take my one that went in?
How much money are you gonna give me for it?
Let's try Simon Lizotte putt. Okay, that didn't, I mean, I made it, but he like, it goes like, I know this looks like I'm being stupid. He like hits the cage and flips it in. Like, how does he do that? It's my most hated hole here, and I've got an ace it. And learn English. To get my goal of 5 under with basically a chief. I'm telling you, if you're sleeping on this disc, pick up a chief because I've played pretty much this entire birdie alley with a chief for the most part, right? Maybe a Houdini here and there. Oh, so close. If I could have missed whatever that was invisible that it hit, then it might have been an ace. But, you know, there's a ghost in the fairway of Matumbo.
Let me show you how to do this. I always land to the left, so I don't know what I'm talking about.
Oh, come on. That's going to be
absolutely it out like perfect. This. Well, these last 3 drives have been the best of my life.
This is my chief. They got slammed down by something invisible over here. That's as good as that's going to get without me being Gannon Burr. And then Mrs. Jenkins Discgolf is up there parked 20 footer. Woo!
Ooh!
Birdied 18.
I will say it's not my first birdie ever, but that's the first actual putt because I threw one in from like way back there once.
Oh, yeah.
But it's my first putt for birdie.
That was such a great tee shot. I struggle on this hole.
I think that tree in the center gets in your head for whatever reason.
My shot is normally like all Anheuser. So I either need to start throwing a Houdini on a steep ante on the inside and letting it pan out and then it would land here and slide up. Or I need to start trusting that this chief will flip over and throw in it flat and finish in my follow through on Anheuser. So that's birdie alley out here at Otter Creek Park.
For me, the front 9 is my birdie opportunity. Probably the front 11. And then once you hit 13, I'm just hanging on.
And mine are kind of just peppered in there. Like I usually shoot about 9 under here, maybe between 9 and 12. On the days that I really shoot good, I've started with a bunch of birdies in the front 9 and just got quite a few in the back 9 as well.
The last 3 holes though were my best drives I've ever had on all 3 holes though.
She was smashing. Like hole 17 matched my drive. That was like 280 worth of power probably. Hole 18 had a really good like hyzer flip to flip over, which is crazy. So that means she's getting a lot of speed on that Underworld for it to flip. All in all, I say we had a pretty good round, pretty fun day out here at Otter Creek Park. Our scores are gonna be on the screen right now. You can actually follow me on UDisc now. And if I post a UDisc round, it'll post on there like it does Facebook with their new like community feature. So that's pretty neat. If you guys are enjoying this kind of content, be sure to like and subscribe to the channel. And here's another video that YouTube thinks you might enjoy from me. Have a great day.
Stay in the fairway.
Come check out Otter Creek. It's one of the oldest courses in Kentucky, and I tried to play it a little old school today and just throw putters and slower discs, something like they would have had maybe when it was first put in.
And it's really like beginner friendly. I love it.